Hi, decoding canvas signals is fairly easy in PicoScope. However, there are some traps to fall into if you are using it for the very first time. To decode canvas, it's enough to connect your probe tip to can L or low, or can H or high line. And then you connect your probe's ground to can ground. Do be careful if your canvas device is not at the same ground potential as your scope. This can actually cause damage. If you are using your laptop with PicoScope, it's quite easy to isolate oscilloscope and prevent issues by simply unplugging the charger. While you can depend on your hand to keep steady connection to canvas, for any longer monitoring, I recommend making a cable. Simply buy the cheapest scope leads with either bare wire or cheap grabbers, and connect those in line with your canvas connection. Once you have physical connection sorted out and you are in PicoScope application, first make sure to trigger on canvas traffic. Since I'm probing on a low line, appropriate trigger level would be 2 volts or so. For high line, 3 volts would be a good starting point. Selecting auto and appropriate voltage will trigger the canvas traffic reliably in my case. To make best of screen real estate, I also like to move trigger point a bit further to the left. 5% is not a bad place. Once that's done, I change time base to see as much signal as possible on the display. With 125K baud that I'm using for my canvas, 100 microseconds per division seems okay. Now we can finally set the canvas decoding by going into Tools, Serial Decoding, and then clicking on Create and finally selecting CAN protocol. In my case, channel is A, threshold level can stay at 1.7 volts, baud rate is 125 kilobaud, and signal has to be low. Few OKs later and you can see each message decoded. In addition to the code values below the waveform, there is also a window at the bottom showing the same information. If you switch there to all buffers, you can see history of your decoded messages. Hope this helps you.